The masking tools in Lightroom are powerful tools that help you add layers and depth into your images. And once I found this hidden intersect button in the masking panel, it changed the way that I use masking to help my photos pop. In this video, I'm gonna teach you three ways that I've learned to use this new tool in Lightroom. And I'm sure once you guys understand the concepts, you'll be able to find a whole bunch of new ways to use this tool as well. But this is how I've found out how to use it. Okay, so I'm gonna start here by adding some standard masks that are typical when you're editing your photos. So one of those masks would be a linear gradient filter. So you can use this by, you know, dragging it from the bottom and will decrease exposure. This is a pretty standard way of using that mask. Another way you could do it is hit M again, we'll grab a new one, drag it from the side that the sun is coming from, and add exposure to make motivated light. Now, the way that I'm gonna show you guys how to use this is we're gonna hit select sky here, and the AI is gonna automatically select the sky. Now, if I decrease the exposure on that sky, it decreases the exposure evenly across the whole sky, leaving kind of a weird outline on the mountains here. So what we're gonna do to get to this hidden tool, we're gonna hit Option or Alt on Windows, and you can see this hidden button pops up. It's called Intersect. And what that does is if we press that, we can now intersect that with another masking tool. So we're gonna grab the linear gradient here, and it's gonna drag down from the top, and now that sky mask is only gonna be impacted by whatever we drag this gradient tool on. So here's the before and after, but you can see that that makes a much more natural, obviously graduated mask there. All right, so the second really powerful way that you can use this tool is in dodging and burning in a controlled environment. And what I mean by a controlled environment here is I'm actually gonna come up here, we're gonna create a new mask, select subject, it's gonna select our Porsche there. So what I wanna do is I wanna add exposure into the dark areas. So mainly what I'm looking at is the rear tail lights, the rear exhaust areas, and into the wheel areas as well. So I'm gonna add exposure here and a little bit of contrast so it sits more naturally. Then we're gonna hit Option or Alt, and we're gonna click this intersect button, and I'm gonna intersect it with a brush. So what this is gonna do is now wherever I brush this in, that's gonna be exposed how we just set it. So I'm gonna brush over the back area here, and it's just gonna impact where I brush in. And again, if I go outside of this car, it's not gonna brush anything in because we've used that isolated tool of our subject. So it's only gonna brush in the parts that I want it to on the car here. So I'm gonna come over here and brush in the details on this tire as well. And you can also see that if you were dealing with a human subject, how you could brush in dodging and burning, adding light to very specific places. So there we've added some dodging, so adding light. You can rename that mask here. And if you wanted to do the same thing, you just create a new mask, select subject. And if we wanted to add burning, so decreasing light and adding a bit of edge to it, we can do the same thing by intersecting that layer and brushing in some dark areas, adding contrast to just the points we want. What's great about this is that after you're done brushing those in, is you can come in and adjust the levels of anything that you want exposed there after you've dodged and burned. Dodging and burning is a great way to bring out details in your subject and add more contrast or depth into the darker areas to make it stand out. Now, one final example I'll show you, and again, we'll use this photo because it's a great example, is after you've added your presets or you've gotten your colors to where you want them. In this photo, for example, we've got a white car that is looking a bit red and blue. So I wanna actually bring this back to its natural color without impacting the background or the foreground, because I like the way that the colors look in the image. So again, what we're gonna do is create a new mask. We're gonna select the subject, and then we're gonna intersect this with a color range tool. Now over here, we're seeing a lot of the reds and it's not really looking very white. So we're gonna come up to this refine tool once we have our color range. So we're gonna select that color range tool, and we're gonna refine exactly what this is impacting. So once we have that refined where we want it, you can see that this is the color here that it's seeing, and we're going to then desaturate that and bring this car back to a white image. Now we still want it to look like it sits naturally in this environment, but that's one really quick way to make the whites stand out in your car. So here's an example of a fall look, but these white rims on this car maybe aren't coming out fully white. So another way that we can pull just the white out is, let's say we grab a radial gradient and we come over top of these tires here, and then we hold option, intersect with color range tool. We're gonna grab the whites here. And as you can see, Lightroom is telling us what color it's grabbing there. We can refine to just the white wheels. And then from here, we are pulling out the saturation to make sure that those look just pure white. And if we wanted to, we could even bring those details out a little bit. And this is what it looks like before and after. It's a very subtle difference, but if you want to get true white or true colors back in whatever car, vehicle, human, cat, whatever you guys are photographing, this is a great tool that gives you a lot of power to refine those adjustments in your photos. Now I'm gonna show you another really cool thing on this photo that I'm actually just thinking of right now. It's a pretty cool way to use the built-in AI to select out just the background of your photos and make some pretty cool adjustments there. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take a new mask, we're gonna take a linear gradient, and we're actually gonna drag it hard down over the sky, over the car here, and we just wanna impact this mountain and these trees to bring out some of the details, the contrast, and even some of the clarity of that. So all we're gonna do is come up here and we're gonna hit subtract, select sky, and we're gonna subtract, select subject. And then now you can see here that we are actually just impacting the background. So from here, we can dehaze, we can add clarity, we can do whatever we want with these colors to really make the background stand out. Or, because in this photo, we're actually trying to draw our attention to the car, is we can actually take away exposure or clarity or whatever. But that way you have full control over just the background of this image. So that's pretty cool. Now, if you guys are into automotive photography, I've got some incredible presets on my website linked down below. Use this code to get 20% off all of my Lightroom presets. And I wanna thank Movo for sending the microphones that we are using in this video. They're wireless and super easy to use. They come with this really cool charging case as well that make it super easy for content creators like me to kind of get up and running really, really quickly. So thanks guys so much for watching. If you guys want to see more car photography tutorials, check these out here. Otherwise, I hope to see you in the next one. Peace.